the guru of squat doubles is the assassin like no other. Yes, I'm the best at what I do. One of the most notorious this YouTube anime manga community. I say to bring you, what? A Naruto discussion after the main series is done? All these reviewers are pretty much done talking about Naruto unless it's about the last Naruto, the last movie. Or if it's about, you know, this possible upcoming spinoff, you know, what? Short series, final arc jazz kind of thing that's about to drop. But this is me, unexpected one, man. Look, I do what I want to, when I want to, how I want to. Like I'm Luffy on this, I'm straight Luffy status. We here to talk about an important discussion, more or less, right? It's important for those who talk about matchups, for those who talk about understanding the series. I think it's important for the series of Naruto. There's other things I could talk about, like Orochimaru, what happened. We ain't gonna go there. We gotta talk about that Hyuga Neji, right? Yes, at what level he was at. Now, I don't understand why this should even be a question. Hyuga Neji being Kage level. This should full-blown be obvious, and I'll explain why. Number one, let's go back to the facts. This is factual. No matter the result of the Chunin exams, BS, that straight worst usage of Duex Machina in history, I will continue to say that because it was horrible. Regardless of that, Neji was the best amongst their class. If I'm not mistaken, he was the first to reach Jonin level. Neji was the first genius, okay? Yes, you had Sasuke and Naruto on the rise up, and for different reasons. I mean, you could say, well, you know, Neji had the Hyuga Clan Eyes, Byakugan. But it was even stated that Neji excelled and Neji was the greatest ever. Now, Hyuga Nabi may surpass him, but, you know, that's a whole different discussion for another day because we're probably not even going to see that, unfortunately, in the series. But, you know what? Well, you got Naruto the last, so we'll see what happens with that one. But anyways, possibly I'm hearing possible rumors of further movies, kind of how the Battle of God series apparently is going to do a series of Dragon Ball. This dude Neji reached Jonin level, belts of young age, you know, I guess others reach at young age, whatever, right? Now I've argued that with enough time he could have possibly surpassed Uchiha Itachi. Now many people think that's crazy, but hey, we don't know the full extent of what the Byakugan could do. We never were shown the full extent of what the Byakugan could do, especially considering the fact that Neji got off. But regardless of that, now we see at what levels Uchiha Sasuke, Uzumaki Naruto, and Gaara are all at. We see this. Gaara was a Kage. May I repeat? Gaara was a Kage. Naruto and Sasuke had already reached Kage level before the so-called 4th grade Shinobi War. It's factual. And again, Neji was before all of these cats. He hit Jonin level before all three of these cats. You had Rock Lee, who could have thrown hands with Tsunade. I'm just saying, though, you could take that L, but it wouldn't have been an easy battle. That's five dudes. Now, four dudes from Konoha, another dude from, what's the sand village called? I can't think of the name right now, but it's the sand village, y'all know what I'm talking about. In the land of the wind. All these dudes from that generation. All these young bloods. You feel me? Now, here's the thing. Number one, could they have beaten Kakashi? Gaara had a good chance of beating Kakashi. Naruto, Sasuke could definitely beat Kakashi. Rock Lee would be an interesting battle. Neji, yes, he could. Yeah, I give Gaara beating Kakashi. I give Neji beating Kakashi too. And why not? show me what Kakashi gonna bring to the table. And Kakashi was confirmed sixth Hokage. Confirmed. Just another ring on the tier. So, you know, before this, before the final, you know, two chapters came out, I was gonna do this video, but, you know, other things came up, brother busy and whatnot. But now, confirmed Kakashi sixth Hokage. Neji to beat Kakashi. Post-time skip Neji would have took that L to Kakashi. What did, tell me, to you Kakashi fans, what is Kakashi bringing to the table that's going to beat Neji? Okay? Before I have to, you know, I'm not going to pull up all of Neji's techniques. Okay? But what I will bring to the table, because what is this important discussion here, is Neji versus Tsunade. It should be obvious that Neji beats Tsunade. It should be obvious. He goes straight for the heart. She's done. She's done, ladies and gents. People talk about, oh, her throwing around the environment. How is that supposed to, is that supposed to phase him? He's got the Byakugan. Almost 360 degree vision. His range, his radius was what, 800 meters, if I'm not mistaken? If not more? The dude, and come on, the rotating palms? Is dude a shinobi? A genius, quote unquote genius shinobi? You tell me you couldn't dodge? Can you, you know, bro, could he use substitution juices? Didn't need to. He's a shinobi. She has, Tsunade has no long range techniques. She has to come in and fight Taijutsu. If she comes into his range, it's over. She getting them hands put on her. People talk about her mitonic regeneration. Her regeneration, great. She needs chakra. Chakra gets blocked. Not only that, people don't understand about the gentle fish Taijutsu. It was clearly stated by Kakashi, my god, okay? How lethal this was. It's worse than my guys and Rock Lee's Taijutsu, because there's his external. The Genno Fist of the Hyuga clan is an internal Taijutsu. It damages your organs. It doesn't just block your chakra. That's something that a lot of Naruto fans, a lot of fandom forgets. It blocks your chakra, but it also impacts your internal organs. Right? He can kill her at the heart. That's just one example. Where's the regeneration without the chakra? And I'm not gonna, look, people saying, oh, you know, landing a shot, will she? Maybe. But regardless, she's taking that L. She's taking that L. Will she hits hard? Okay, and? She has no speed. That's the problem. She has no speed. What speed? Show me some speed feats for Tsunade. I understand she's a legendary Sanin, but this is a bad matchup. This is really bad matchup. Okay? A Taijutsu master, and yes he is. He's a Taijutsu master. Push the Byakugan usage and the Genno Fist mastery beyond anything that at least we're aware of within the series. Now, there may have been some ancient, you know, dude in the past. We'll see. But as far as we know, Hyuga Neji's best is what it is. Now, when it comes to Gaara, it'd be a very interesting matchup. Neji could get Gaara, but it really comes down to who's... Well, see, here's the thing. Gaara's stamina is not all that good. It's not all that good. It comes down to a bunch of defense. It'd be a very, very tough battle, to say the least. Very tough battle. Neji has a high probability of getting Gaara. That's two Kage taken down. The Raikage. Neji has a possibility of beating Raikage. It'd be ridiculously hard. Ain't gonna front. He may not come out of that alive. He may not. But he may take the eye of the Raikage with him. I understand the whole lightning armor. I understand the speed. But again, that rotating heaven. And the vacuum fist, if I'm not mistaken, where he can push and hit you with his own chakra and whatever. It'd be a very interesting battle, to say the least. Again, I'm not sure who's coming out of the one alive. The Mizukage, however you want to say it, she'd be a tough matchup as well because of her lava style, because of her water. I believe she can hit you from long range, so that'd be tough for Neji. It'd be really tough. He stands a chance, but that may just be a bad matchup for him. And when it comes to Inoki to Tsuchikage, this is definitely a bad matchup, dog. He's probably taking that L to Inoki because, you know, Inoki can kind of float / fly in midair. He also has the abilities of the planetary, jutsu and all that kind of junk. But so yeah, Inoki's probably taking that from distance and otherwise. It's a bad sign. But it doesn't mean Neji can't throw a fight. But when the fact is, I'm not including Arn. Well, yeah, he wouldn't go. Well, see, that's further in the future. Would you beat Naruto at the time before the Sage of Six Paths power up? I don't know. Probably not, but I don't know. Don't kill me. I don't know. But again, Naruto, he was Kage level, but he wasn't ready to be Hokage. So, you know, take that for what it's worth. But could he beat Naruto? I don't know. Can't say, because we didn't really see much from Neji post Sasuke before the war. Don't know. Really don't. Probably not, but don't know. Could he beat Tsunade? Absolutely. Kakashi, very likely. Guards, possible. Raikage, tough, but he's probably. Mizukage, probably not, but depends. And Tsuchikage, probably most deaf taking that L. Unexpected one, like, comment, subscribe. These are my thoughts. What are yours? How can you not put Neji Kage level? To me, that's just ludicrous. That's not paying any attention to the series. You gotta understand power levels. Just because you aren't necessarily on par with another character does not mean you're on that level. I mean, does not mean you're not on that level. It doesn't mean you're not on that level. I mean, Tsunade, I'm sorry. She's taking an L to pretty much every single one of the other Kages. Doesn't mean she's not on Kage level. I mean, she's taking an L to both Orochimaru and Jiraiya. Doesn't mean she's not on that level. You understand what I'm saying? But till next time, y'all, have a beautiful day, beautiful night. Peace.